also from the Dream Builders and Walt Disney. It's kind of fun to do the impossible. It's week 17, training for the Dopey Challenge, and I'm at Walt Disney World at Hollywood Studios because my Boston running buddy is here visiting with his wife and his son. We're just having some fun this week. Two 45-minute maintenance runs and a 5-miler at the end of the week, but I'm going to increase those maintenance runs to a minimum of 5 miles each for the remainder of this training period going through the next 10 weeks. And also, Halloween's coming up. Look, my Mickey pumpkin. Got to start decorating, plus I'm waiting for a new computer and a new gimbal so I can get back to working on the videos. Hey, you hear the dwarves? They want me to go out and start working, start actually doing the runs, but I'm going to have some fun first.
Do you want to go on a ride, Scott?
So is that juice? You know, the holidays can be really hectic with these Run Disney training plans, and for some of you who saw my goofy running videos, you know I like to get a bit creative to blow off some steam. I had an elaborate plan for this year's Halloween with some atmosphere effects, digital downloads, a projector, and Hallusion material. I'll put a link in the description below, but with my new computer, a replacement gimbal, and some new running shoes, my budget is shot. So instead, I'm going to take a flat panel, those digital downloads, some wood, and I'm gonna make a very scary portrait. It's a really easy supply list. About $20 in 1x2s and 1x3s to frame around the flat panel, some molding to act as the picture frame, and then some scrap 2x3 and 2x4 that I can use to make a stand to the floor. Plus some screws and brad nails to put the whole thing together. It's only about a dozen cuts, but I need somebody to help me set up the chop saw and the air compressor so I don't end up looking like that because of the vision problems. Remember, measure twice, cut once. In my case, measure 10 times. Hey, look, it's Christmas in July. Actually, it's more like the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown, bringing me things I need to replace computers that are wearing out and equipment that's become faulty. This is a new computer. That's the new gimbal. And in the little pack, a surprise. I'm not sure I'm going to reveal it just yet because it's something for the Walt Disney World Marathon weekend. Let me tear into this, show you what I've got. I'm not going to do a complete review, just going to show you so I can get back to work on my videos. With this mess, I should have said Christmas in October. Let me go over this very quickly. This is a replacement Feiyu TEch G5 gimbal. You're probably wondering, why would I go with the same thing when the other one went bad on me? Well, this is an updated version. It comes with some special features like a new trigger, and it has some padding to help with the audio issues. But most importantly, I like this because it has an 8-hour battery life and it's waterproof. Now, Feiyu TEch has finally gotten back to me. They are sending me a new socket board, but I've actually reached back to them and asked them to send me some instructions because I just don't know how I'm gonna fix this thing with my eyesight issues. So hopefully they'll send me instructions on how to repair the old gimbal, this one right here, and then maybe I'll have two, including one as a backup. Now, I did go with a new computer. This is the MSI Multistar International GS63VR. It's one of the top gaming computers on the market right now. The reason I went with this is because I need something future-proof, something that can handle 4K video now and for the next several years. And this is a pretty good computer. Now, normally I would have gone with a 17-inch screen. This time I only went with a 15-inch. I realized after a number of years of using my Asus Republic of Gamer computer, I never really use the screen. I always plug it into an external monitor, and I always use Zoom software to help me because of the visual impairment. So this is the new computer. And finally, for a costume. Now, all I'm gonna say is I often dream of a far-off place. If you can think of that one, this is an old, outdated pattern that was discontinued probably, I don't know, 20 years ago. I got my hands on one on Etsy. We'll see if this makes it to the Walt Disney World Marathon weekend. I may save it for a future race. The Dream Builder motto, get started and begin doing. So I did not take the camera with me on the first two runs of the week, and I did pretty well. Here's what they look like. I did a 10:38 pace for the first maintenance run of 5 miles, a little over 5 miles, and I did a 9:52 pace for the second maintenance run, 5.22 miles. That's really good for me. And the reason, it was only 72 degrees, it was early, and there was a really nice breeze. I am gonna take the camera out for the last run of the week. 5, 4.
Workout started.
Final run of the week, I think it's training routine number 54. I put this off till the last day of the week, which is not good because you don't get a buffer. I used my buffer. So I'm taking this a little slowly this morning, a little more slowly than normal, because I finally got my new ASICS gel Kayanos, and I'm breaking them in. They're a bit stiff, so I don't want to hurt my shins and my calves. About an 11:30 pace will be fine. So it's really warm. 7 a.m., 7:30, and it's 75 degrees, but it's going to cool down. It'll be about 20 degrees colder, almost, in about 4 days at this time. Bunch of things are conspiring to keep me slow this morning. I'm testing out the new G5 gimbal from Feiyu TEch. It's got a couple of new features as the second version, a trigger lock. Looks like it's handling the weight a little better. You know, I can't see normally what I'm shooting at in the distance, but from here I use my peripheral vision to try to make out if the camera is level or not. Let me finish this thing up. You may be able to see that my wood here on the stand was a bit warped, the wood I got at Home Depot, but it worked out because I got the picture frame level. Final few steps, then I get to clean up.
Thank you.
Bit spooky, huh? That's just a quick preview for you. I'm going to add a Bluetooth speaker to the back of this thing, try to scare the trick-or-treaters. You'll see it with the display Halloween Week Expo video. Can I get two refills?
Hey everybody, Ryan!
So we are wrapping up the day here at the studios, and you're probably wondering why I'm always holding my phone like this and talking into it. This is a great way to get clean audio if you don't have a microphone hooked up to your GoPro or your action camera. Just download a free voice recorder and use it separately. Just give it something to sync to when you use your program. A couple of snaps like that and you can sync both the audio and the video. So while we wrap up the day here, you should know that my new computer, which I got 24 hours ago, is actually not working. A lot of money. I was going to give you the price, but I don't need to do that. A lot of money. And the actual hard drive, the second one that should have been working on it, is not connected. I called them, and I'm going to give you the name because I'm a little disappointed in their customer service. iBuyPower, which is a large gaming company, keeps telling me that they want me to try to fix a computer that's 12 hours out of the box, and it makes me quite angry. They should be offering to get me a new one, and now we're going to have to try to figure out what's going on with that. Hey, remember, you can keep me motivated. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already done so. Give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment below. Tell me what you think about these electronic issues. I want to tell you something. It's going to make me pull my hair out. I just want to get back to doing my videos. Coming up next time, it's going to be another easy week going into Halloween and going into Wine and Dine Week. The next week coming up, the Magic Mile.